If you want to modify the rows of a financial report based on dimension structures, it's very similar to an account group-based report. You have the ability to summarize or expand a particular dimension structure, and you can modify the dimension structures that are included within the report from the report itself. You can also modify the dimension structure and the dimension groups that that dimension structure is based on. The easiest place to find all of your dimension groups is to come into the Setup tab in the Projects section, and you can find the various groups for most situations. You can also find anywhere that groups are available in the Setup tab for a given section. You can set up the groups for those. Let's take a look at the Projects group, and we can see that we have several groups set up for projects. We're going to take a look at the active projects for now. So if we open up the edit for that, we can see that we can define kind of familiar to us from across the system some basic header information for it, name, description, and then we have some setup for the group itself. So within the dimension, we can define it as being all members or specific members and then filter. And then we also have some sort options, as well as a maximum number of matches to include within the group for reporting purposes. You can also set up additional conditions if you need to, as well as the filters. Once you have your group defined, you can go ahead and modify your dimension structures. Dimension structures can be found in general ledger, and then you choose your particular dimension that you're looking to base that on. Let's take a look at the project structures. We can see that there's an active projects structure to match the active projects group. Go ahead and take a look at the edit screen for that, and you can see in here that you can define a very similarly to the account groups, the dimension structures that make up a dimension group. So you could include additional dimension groups within your structure to have your included values. So if you wanted to include the active projects and the on-hold projects, or the active projects and the inactive and not the on-hold, you could do that in here and have something like projects not on hold as your structure. So slightly more complex than an account group, but generally the same idea. You're going to set up a filter to pull particular transactions out of the GL based on a given filter on a dimension. And then you can combine one or more of those filters to make a structure, and that structure can power the rows of your report.